So it's super important you have your calculator in press to test mode. To do that, make sure first of all it's turned off, and then press escape and on at the same time. And you'll get into the menu about trying to get into press to test. Now try not to click OK or OK down here, right? Because there are certain features along here that you're allowed and certain features that you're not allowed. So press the up arrow very delicately. And you're allowed sliders, you're allowed a numerical solver, you're allowed polynomial root finder, you're allowed the log base template, you're allowed limit trig functions, and you are allowed inequality graphing, although you might never use it. Okay, so this is the format that you're allowed to have your calculator in. When you get to the top here, it's important that you choose which is your default angle. Now you can switch between degrees and radians once you've put it into press to test mode, but why not get it on the right setting to start with, the most prevalent one that you're going to use. Once you've done that, all the way back to the start and enter press to test mode. And what that effectively does is it stops you accessing My Documents. Now My Documents is a place where you could store all kinds of previous information, and you will not be able to access anything else that you have stored. And also you'll see there's now a flashing button there, an indication to people it's in press to test. When we go down now, if we go across to browse, there are no documents that you can actually open. So that's what press to test does for you. Now of course that's the first part. The second part is, imagine that you did this the day before your exam, and then you decided to do a little bit of work as revision, as you probably would do, and you did some really hard calculations, and now you turn that off again. Now let's say you walk into the exam the next day, and the exam invigilator is going around, your teacher, and you just happen to turn on your calculator, and you go, oops, you have data stored on your calculator. And even this with one tab open here will be classified as storing data. And that is a big no-no in any exam you have. Now, the simple way to get rid of this is every time you walk into your exam, turn the calculator off and then press escape on again, as you did before to go into press to test. And I have an option of reset press to test. When you reset press to test and OK, you'll find that all access to that previous document is now gone. Okay, so that's important that we get it into press to test mode, which is great, but more importantly, once it's in press to test mode, escape on reset press to test. That'll just wipe out any previous documents that you've been using since it was first put into press to test. Okay, hope that helps. Top tip as well, once you've finished your exam, this blinking light can be a bit of a drain on the battery. So you can ask your friendly maths teacher to take this out of press to test. You can only do it with a special cable, so that will save the battery drainage once you're passed your exam or your test.